Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Ron Mackenzie Lafergie. Pinching the loaf, loosing the caboose, busting a grumpy, dropping the kids off at the pool. Everybody does it, we have a million names for it, and you may even be doing it while you watch this video, but what if we never had to engage in this smelly daily ritual again? Let's explore. By the way, today we have a new sponsor, Australian Excellence. While this video is focused on a world without pooping, Australian Excellence knows that it's a reality we all face. Many believe that when it comes to digestive health, antacids, steroids, and antibiotics are the name of the game. But Australian Excellence understands that there are ways to work with your body to help it function better rather than simply covering up symptoms. With a combination of a potent herbal formula and a carefully assembled probiotic, you can strengthen the GI tract and help the immune system to function properly. If this interests you, head to shop.australianexcellence.com where you can purchase both the Digestive Excellence and the Probiotic Excellence supplements with a 90-day money-back guarantee. Now get ready, it's time to ask the question, what if we stopped pooping? Of course, when you first saw this question, you may have pictured someone slowly inflating until they exploded. If you've seen Monty Python's The Meaning of Life, you'll probably picture this scene. Of course, if we were to stop pooping altogether but continue to take food in, we would eventually run out of room and explode. For this reason, this video will assume that somehow humanity had changed such that we no longer need to poop, and our food magically departs our bodies after being digested. So what would this turdless world look like? Well, there are a number of changes that we might see. First and foremost, washrooms would be cleaner and would smell way better. This would be great when sharing a bathroom with others, would make using public washrooms much less disgusting, and could eliminate some awkward moments on dates. Furthermore, people around the world would find themselves with considerably more time on their hands. Depending on one's regularity, one could gain hours of spare time each week without the need to pop a squat every so often. It's possible that this would result in an increase in activities and hobbies, but let's be real, we'd probably just watch more Netflix. This would, of course, be especially beneficial to those suffering from digestive disorders. It's estimated that irritable bowel syndrome affects 10 to 15% of adults in the US, and it can significantly affect the lives of sufferers. Many IBS sufferers spend hours each day on the toilet and are kept in or near their home for fear of leaving the house and being hit by a sudden urge. If pooping was no longer a concern, the world would open up for these people. No longer would they be prisoners to the porcelain god, they could wander around to their heart's content without fear. When it comes to digestion, one might assume that if people stopped pooping, there would be no more need for gut-related products and specialty doctors. But that's not the case. The digestive system is very much involved in how the body works as a whole. Even though you wouldn't need to worry about diarrhea, you'd still want all the physical and psychological benefits of a well-functioning digestive system. For this reason, proper nutrition and digestive care would still be vital in order to assure that your mind and body will continue to function efficiently. However, that's not to say that everyone would follow these rules. Without pooping habits to keep people appraised of their digestive situation, many people would choose much less healthy foods. There's a lot we can learn from our poop. It shows us if we're eating something we shouldn't, if we're getting too much or too little of certain things, but without poops to keep them honest, some would be tempted to take advantage of the lack of BMs and would mostly eat junk food. Probiotics and leafy greens might give way to chips and candy, something that our bodies would not be happy about. This could lead to even more vitamin deficiency, more obesity, and more overall poor health than is currently seen in the Western world. But hey, the world doesn't revolve around the West. This would also have significant ramifications in the developing world. One child dies every 21 seconds from a water-related disease, and the lack of clean water in many African nations causes millions to die of dehydration due to dysentery. If people couldn't get diarrhea anymore, there would be less concern about the resulting dehydration, and these diseases might become less deadly. Not only that, but it would eliminate an important vector for the spread of the disease, which would cause fewer people to become ill in the first place. On the other hand, this lack of diarrhea could actually be a bad thing in certain cases. There's a reason humans react to certain things by peeing from their bum. When we take in harmful pathogens, our body attempts to excrete them in a number of ways, including vomiting, sneezing, and yes, having diarrhea. So those African people who no longer died of the lost fluids from dysentery would still have the pathogen in their systems, and might have trouble clearing them. That said, if we'd reached a point in medical science where we could eliminate pooping, there's a good chance that we would have sorted out elimination of pathogens as well. And now we return to our question, what if we stopped pooping? Well, first of all, bathrooms would smell a whole lot better thanks to the lack of smelly poos. People would find themselves with more time on their hands, particularly those suffering from digestive disorders, or who would experience much more freedom without fear of emergencies. Healthy eating and digestive aids, despite still being important, might be less common, since the consequences would be less noticeable. Furthermore, without diarrhea, a good number of those who would have died of dysentery might survive, particularly since many viruses and bacteria depend on defecation to spread. However, this would also make it more difficult to pass whatever pathogen would have caused the diarrhea in the first place. Thank you for watching Life's Biggest Questions. I hope this was interesting and informative, and maybe even inspired you to look into it further on your own. If you like this video, please thumbs up and subscribe to the channel down below. While you're down there, let me know if you'd rather never have to poop again or never have to sleep again. Big thank you once again to Australian Excellence. I've been making good use of their products with encouraging results, and if you feel your digestion simply isn't up to par, head on over to shop.australianexcellence.com to give it a try. Until next time, I'm Ron McKenzie-Lafergie with Life's Biggest Questions, wishing you the best of luck on your quest for answers.